So a number of times in the last while, they've asked us to do a thought experiment. And I'd like to invite, and I invite you to do that again this morning, a little differently. So, as in the past, imagine there's a smallish whiteboard in front of you. You have a marker. And take a moment and consider the things that scare you, the things you're afraid of, the things that scare you, that you feel fear around. And take a moment and write them on the whiteboard related to health or family or money. Social justice, the snowblower, gotta get that tuned up. All the things that you have fear around, children, family, when you're ready, take your eraser and erase the things on that list that you have control over. Be honest. What do you have control over that's on that list, the things that scare you? One of the things about the Buddhist tradition that really got my attention a long time ago was the recognition that I'm responsible for me. I'm influenced by countless conditioned situations. I'm influenced by countless people and books and movies and ideas and arguments and lovers and so on and so on. I'm responsible for me. There was a time when I tried to put my difficulties on God. And then I figured out I didn't know what that even meant. So it wasn't really that good of an idea. But desperate times call for desperate. In the Buddhist tradition, the Buddha Dharma is about me looking at who I am, how I feel, what ideas I carry, and understanding where they come from and how they drive the bus. And do the feelings that are generated by day-to-day life, in the moment or in the long term, are those feelings driving the bus? And if so, what can I do about it? In the world of psychology, fear is usually defined as an emotion involving real or imagined situations. unconscious if you did a good job on your whiteboard, most of the things that came off your whiteboard were imagined. This might happen. This might occur. Is that true? Mm-hmm. Move. Damn mess. Can't read anybody's facial expressions. Everybody's just a mummy. I bring this up, I suppose it's obvious, because we live in a time of fear. We live in a time of fear. Someone said to me a few weeks ago when I was in a conversation, one of the interminable conversations about COVID, somebody said, you have to live your life as though everybody is sick. That's terrible. I should be afraid of you.
You should.
I've been afraid of you for a long time. And of course, I think that's true. I think that in some way that's an accurate description of how we should live in these times. Because it's just confusing and so little is really understood. On the other hand, fear, in my judgment, is the most insidious, destructive human emotion there is. Forget this COVID stuff, this will be gone someday. But fear will always be our friend. Fear will always be around. Relationships and parents and job and health and da 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 da. Fear is insidious, it gets down inside our DNA, I think. Interferes with our ability to relax and enjoy the great gift of this day, this amazing day. And in my various roles in life, I've seen how absolutely ruinous fear can be. Absolutely ruinous. People withdraw into themselves, withdraw into balls of insecurity and anxiety and distrust based on fear. And it's almost always stuff isn't even on the list. It's in the heart. It's in the past. It's not real. It's not here now. So as with all things in the Buddha Dharma, we look for the middle ground. We look for the middle way. You better be careful. This COVID shit is serious. And if we allow it to dominate our life will be really, really small. And it will affect everything about us. Our relationships, how we sleep, how we eat, how we exercise, how we work, so on and so on and so on. I judge that that's unhealthy. Because I also know that the science tells us very clearly that fear makes us sick. You know that? Anxiety makes us sick. So on the one hand, to be very concerned. On the other hand, to find the moderation, to find the middle ground. Have to be careful driving on the highway at 60 miles an hour. Well, nobody goes 60. That's 72 miles an hour. Have to be careful. The odds of something happening are very, very small, probably immeasurably small. But you better pay attention because there is a possibility something bad could happen. And it's that in all these things that we have fear about. There's a middle ground. Find the middle path. Find a way to still live your life, to still be joyful in relationship, to be able to dance and sing and have fun, and be careful. And please understand that fear is a very, very unhealthy way to live. Very, very unhealthy way to live. I would guess if we discussed it, you would all have a story about it. So on that cheerful note, we should go have coffee. Any comments or thoughts?